did suffer, brethren. To others, it's still Blessed Preparation Day. We have just entered the holy hours, especially in Africa and other continents in the world. Today, we want to look at an interesting topic, but it contains it has to do with our lives now. It is the judgment for the living. From 1844, we have been studying, we have been proclaiming the judgment for the dead. But we know that the living are also going to be judged. Now, shall we look at 4SP, page 314, paragraph 3.
314.3.
Yes.
Solemn are the sins connected with the closing work of the atonement.
Mm-hmm.
Momentous are the interests therein involved.
Mm-hmm.
The judgment is now passing in the sanctuary above.
Mm-hmm.
40 years has this work been in progress.
Yes.
Soon, none know how soon, it will come to pass to the cases of the living.
Mm-hmm.
In the awful presence of our God, our lives are to come up in review.
Mm-hmm.
At this time, above all others, mm-hmm. it behooves every soul mm-hmm. to heed the Savior's admonition.
Yes.
Watch and pray,
mm-hmm.
for ye know not when the time is. Watch ye therefore,
mm-hmm.
lest coming suddenly ye find you sleeping.
So God has already forewarned us through the servant of God, Mrs. Ellen G. White, that soon none knows how soon the judgment will pass to the cases of the living. We know from 1844, the judgment started for the dead. The investigative judgment started for the dead. And it closes with us, the living. But no one knows when it starts. That's what the spiritual prophecy said. But when it starts, we know there are things that are expected as God judges the living. Shall we look at Great Controversy, page 593, paragraph 2.
Point 2.
Yes.
Those who endeavor to obey all the commandments of the God
mm.
will be opposed and derided.
So those who endeavor to keep all the commandments of God will be opposed and derided. Yes.
They can stand only in God.
Mm-hmm.
In order to endure the trial before them,
yes.
they must understand the will of God
yes.
as revealed in His Word.
Yes. So we need to understand the will of God as revealed in the Word of God. So we need to study the Word and understand the will of God. But we know as we do that, and as we attempt, as we try to keep this the law, and all that God has said to us we should keep, will be opposed and derided. Yes?
They can honor Him
mm-hmm.
only as they have the right conception
mm-hmm.
of His character,
yes.
government,
mm-hmm.
and purposes.
Okay, so we need to understand the character of God, His government, and His purposes. Yes?
And act in accordance with them.
Then we should act according to the character, government, and purpose of God. Yes?
None
mm-hmm.
but those who have fortified the mind with the truths of the Bible
yes.
will stand through the last great conflict.
So if you are not studying the Bible, if you are not fortifying yourself with the truths of the Bible, you won't be able to stand in this judgment. Yes.
To every soul
yes.
will come the searching time.
To every soul will come the searching
test.
So God, as He judges the living, He tests us. So each and every soul is going to be tested by the word of God. Yes.
Shall I obey God?
The test is, shall I obey God as revealed in the Holy Scriptures?
Rather than men.
So in other words, men will be fighting against God through giving false interpretations of the Bible. So one has to be tested whether you want to obey the truth as revealed in the Word of God, or you want to obey men as they detect whatever they want to be followed. Yes?
The decisive hour is even now at hand.
Yes, we are in the decisive hour. We have to choose whether to be saved or to be lost. It's an individual choice. No one has to tamper with that choice. It's your own decision to be saved. to choose to follow the truth, to accept the truth, or to reject the truth. Yes.
Are our feet planted on the rock of God's immutable word?
Yeah.
Are we prepared to stand firm in the defense of the commandments of God and the faith of Jesus?
Yes. So we need to defend the commandments of God and the faith of Jesus. Now, as we defend the faith of Jesus, that's where most people have problems, because they don't know what is in the faith of Jesus. The faith of Jesus is to believe in the saving power that is in Jesus, the blood that was shed on the cross. So how do we show that we have faith in this blood? By doing what the word says we should do with the blood. So just like in the ancient times, when Israel needed to be forgiven their sins, God gave them an instruction to shed the blood. They shed the blood of a lamb that represented Christ. But in our time, Christ has already died. So what has he left for us? We're no longer killing, because when we kill, we are breaking the moral law. So we are no longer killing. He says, have faith in the blood that I've given you. We have faith in the wine that I've given you. Have faith in the bread that I've given you, which represents the body of Jesus Christ. So you just don't take it anyhow. You take it according to the word of God. That's where your test is. So those who defend the plan of salvation and the commandments are the only people who will make it, are the only people who will be, when tested, will be found loyal to the commandments and the faith of Jesus. Let's move on.
Before his crucifixion.
Okay, just leave it there. Can you go to early writings, page 270, paragraph 2, and see what is happening as God is judging the living. Yes, read it for us, please.
I asked the meaning of the shaking.
Yes.
I had seen and was shown that it would be caused by the straight testimony called forth by the counsel of the true witness of the Lord to the Laodiceans.
Okay. So it says, I was shown a shaking, which will be caused by a straight testimony called forth by the counsel of the two witnesses. So there is a straight testimony that God is going to bring to the church to test the living. So what was shown to Sister Ellen White? Yes?
This will have its effect upon the heart of the receiver.
This straight testimony will have an effect to the heart of anyone who receives it, yes?
And will lead him to
exalt the standards.
And pour forth the straight truth.
So this testimony does not leave you in your old condition, but it makes you exalt. Let's move on and see.
Some
will
not bear the straight testimony.
Some will not bear this straight testimony. Very straight. When God tells you, keep the feast, that's a straight testimony. Some will not bear this straight testimony, yes?
They will rise up against
it. A straight instruction from God, yes?
And this is what will cause a shaking amongst
God's
people.
Now, if you look at what is happening today, there is a ministry that is shaking the church. Wherever, doesn't matter where you are, but there is a message that is shaking the people of God. And that is a message that came in 1888. That message, God stopped it when it was rejected, and the angel returned to heaven, and God said, this same message will come again in the last days. And this was the righteousness by faith, which came in 1844. But let's see, this is righteousness by faith, which was to lead us to the righteousness of Christ. Now, let's see how this righteousness was to go on to Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 2. Oh, you can start from verse 1.
Verse 1.
Yes.
Now, these are the commandments,
mm-hmm.
the statutes,
yes.
and the judgments.
So these are three different things. Commandments, statutes, and judgments. Yes.
Which the Lord your God commanded to teach you,
mm-hmm.
that he might do them
mm-hmm.
in the land where he got to possess it.
Do you see these commandments, statutes, and judgments belong to one land? They are not. These are not for all lands. So these are the laws that belong to God, God's land. Yes. Can you go to verse 2?
Verse 2.
Yes.
Thou mayest fear the Lord thy God.
These commandments and statutes and judgments, they lead us to fear. They make us develop the fear of the Lord. So read it again in verse 2.
That thou mightest fear the Lord.
That thou mightest fear the Lord, yes.
Thy God.
Thy God.
To keep all his statutes.
To keep all his statutes.
And his commandments.
And his commandments. So the statutes and commandments, they make us fear God. When we keep them, we demonstrate that we fear God. So we are a wise people that fears God, that keeps his laws that he has given us. Yes, can you go to verse 24 of the same chapter?
Verse 24.
Yes.
And the Lord commanded us to do all these statutes,
mm-hmm.
to fear the Lord our God.
Yes.
For our good always.
So, we fear him for our good. So, when we keep these statutes, it's for our good. Yes.
That he might preserve us alive.
Preserve us alive. He says, when you keep these statutes, we are preserved alive, right? So there is life in keeping of the statutes. So if you don't keep the statutes, there's no life. Let's move on.
That he might preserve us alive.
Yes.
As it is in this day.
Yes.
And the Lord, and it is our righteousness.
Sorry, can you read it again, please?
And it shall be our righteousness.
It shall be our righteousness. When we keep these, it shall be so the statutes make us a righteous people. So this is in 1888, the righteousness of Christ, the righteousness by faith, giving us the righteousness of Christ. So when we keep the commandments, we become a righteous people. That's what the word says. Can you move on to early writings again to 270, paragraph 3.3. Yes.
I saw that the testimony of the true witness has mm-hmm. not been half hidden.
The testimony of the true witness has not been half hidden. Can you imagine that this testimony, which causes a shaking in the church, has not been half hidden? Can you imagine? And people decide to choose certain feasts and reject other feasts. It's half being half heated. Or can you proceed with it?
The solemn testimony upon which the destiny of the church hangs
mm-hmm.
has been lightly esteemed,
mm-hmm.
if not entirely disregarded.
If not entirely disregarded, this testimony has been disregarded. In other areas, you find so many people preach that the feast were nailed to the cross. That is to disregard a straight testimony that God has given us. Yes.
This testimony mm-hmm. must work deep repentance.
This testimony, if anyone accepts it, it works deep repentance. And when we repent, it means we are going to be saved, forgiven our sins and be saved. But the enemy of our souls has taught us that these statutes were nailed to the cross so that there is no deep repentance. So when the judgment of the living comes, this straight testimony tells us to keep the feast, and it shows us there is no single verse that says feast were nailed to the cross. Therefore, some rise up against this straight testimony.
Receive it.
Mm-hmm. and be purified. This is very, very important. We understand because it's anyone who is going to accept it is going to be purified by the truth. Yes.
Said the angel. List ye.
Okay. Just leave it there. Let's okay, go to paragraph 4.4. Yes.
Said the angel, list ye, soon I heard a voice like many musical instruments, all sounding in perfect strength,
yes,
sweet and harmonious.
Yes.
It surpassed any music I had ever heard.
Yes.
Seeming to be full of mercy, compassion, and elevating.
Yes.
Holy joy. It thrilled through my whole being, said the angel.
Yes.
Look ye. My attention was then turned to the company I had seen, who were mightily shaken.
Her attention was now taken to a company who were mightily shaken. She had seen the company that was called a straight testimony to the audition. Yes.
I was shown those who might before sleeping and praying in agony of spirit.
Yes.
The company of guardian angels around them had been doubled.
Take note of that point. The company of guardian angels had doubled. Can you see that as soon as people reject this straight testimony, each person has a guardian angel. But the moment you reject this testimony, which is judging the living, determining who is on the Lord's side, who should be saved, the moment you reject this straight testimony, what happens to the guardian angel? Must depart. And where does the guardian angel go to? To those who are proclaiming this straight testimony. So, Sister Wayne, the people who are declaring this straight testimony, their angels are doubled. This is so encouraging. So that no one needs to fear to proclaim this testimony, because we have the protection from God. The angels come from those who rejected the straight testimony to those who are proclaiming the straight testimony for the need against the enemy. Yes.
And they were clothed with an armor from their head to their feet.
Yes.
They moved in exact order.
Yes.
Like a company of soldiers.
So these are the only ones that are prepared, that take orders, that move in perfect order. Let's leave it there. You can finish it at your own spare time. Now, we want to look at what happened to the church as it left Jerusalem. What happened to the church? Let's go to Revelation chapter 12. Can you go to where the woman fled to the wilderness? The verse.
Verse 6.
Yes, verse 6.
And the woman fled into the wilderness, where she had a place prepared of God.
Yes. So the woman initially was in Jerusalem, and through persecution, fled to the wilderness. So the place outside the vineyard, the place outside Jerusalem, is called the wilderness. So the church went to the wilderness, and she had a place prepared for her for 42 months, which is 20 years. Right? So let's move on and see what happened there.
That they should feed you for 1,203 score days.
Yes. So this 260 years was the time when that woman was to be fed in the wilderness. So it means after this time, that woman was supposed to move back to her place, but she didn't move back to her place. Okay, so what happened? Can you go to verse 9?
Verse 9.
Yeah.
And the great dragon was cast out.
Yes.
That old serpent.
Yes.
Called the devil.
Yes.
And Satan.
Right.
Which deceived the whole world. He was cast up. He was cast out into the earth.
Yes.
And his angels were cast out with him.
Okay, so we see the devil being cast to the earth after the ascension of Christ, after Christ said, yes, yes,
now it's called
yes.
The strength.
Has been accomplished. Now Christ has died for us. Now we can, those who will have faith in the atoning blood can now be saved. So let's proceed again.
And I heard a loud voice saying in heaven,
yes,
now is come salvation.
Now is come salvation.
And strength.
Yes.
And the kingdom of our God.
Yes.
And the power of his Christ.
Mm-hmm.
For the accuser of our brethren is cast down. Before our God,
yes,
day and night.
Right.
And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb.
Amen. So do you see what God left us to help us overcome? It is the blood of Christ. So what we are going to overcome? During those appointed times, in the presence of, as we partake of the bread and wine, as it was given in ancient time. This is the plan of salvation. Yes, move on.
And by the word of their testimony.
Yes. So the word of our testimony, what you testify, make you overcome. Because you can't testify something that you don't believe in. So this is where it is the doer of the word. Yes.
And they loved not their lives unto mm-hmm. death.
Yes.
Therefore, rejoicing
mm-hmm.
heavens.
Okay. It says woe unto.
Yes. And the dragon was. And the dragon saw that he was cast into the earth.
Sorry, can you read it properly? Verse 15.
Verse 15.
Yes.
And the serpent cast out of his mouth water as flood.
Water as the flood. So the dragon cast out water as a
flood.
Yes.
After the woman.
After the woman, yes.
That he might cause her to be carried away by the flood.
Right. That he might cause her to be carried away by the flood. So let's analyze this verse. The dragon cast out water as a flood to the woman. Now, so that the reason why he cast out water to the woman, it has been given it to carry away the water. What did he place in the church?
Verse 15.
Mm-hmm.
The waters which thou sowest,
mm-hmm.
where the world seated,
mm-hmm.
are peoples,
mm-hmm.
and multitudes,
mm-hmm.
and nations,
mm-hmm.
and tongues.
Right. The waters that you see are peoples, multitudes, nations, kings, and tongues. So you see, these are people that were placed into the church. These are from all nations, from all languages. So we see that in every place where the church is, the devil planted his people in that church. And the reason is to carry away the woman. So the devil did not leave the woman. The woman fled to the wilderness because of the persecution by the devil. But he followed there and cast now flood. Many people into the church, which were to carry away the woman. So let's analyze again how they were to carry away the woman. Let's see whether this event was also seen in SOP. Let's go to volume 5, Testimonies for the Church, volume 5. Testimonies for the Church, Volume 5, page 217. Testimonies for the Church, Volume 5, page 217, paragraph 2.
The Church has turned back from following Christ the leader.
The Church has turned back from following Christ the leader. This already shows that what the devil wanted to do at that particular year, it was accomplished. Of God. So the first thing when God wants true worship is to introduce the correct calendar. So they were told today is the beginning of the year, it is the beginning of the month. So they were told it was the beginning of the month as they left Egypt. Can you go to verse chapter 13 of Exodus, verse 4, and see what month that was, as they were told that today is the first month of the year and the first day of the month. Yes?
Verse 4.
Yes.
This day kept me out in the month of Abib.
This day came out in the month of Abib. So it's the first month of the year. So I'm sure some people already know that we are in the seventh month. Well, I mean, which is the month of Iron, and on tomorrow sunset, Sabbath sunset, we are entering which is the month of Sivan. So all this is in the Bible. These months are in the Bible. The calendar of God is in the Bible. But you see now what Sister White is saying, that the Church is talking. Back to Egypt, where there is no calendar, where there is no about this. I'm sure you know how is the speed of the flood and the power which is in the flood. So this is the spiritual power which is in the church, which has changed what God gave us to give us what man wants. So this is what the SOP is trying to tell us, that this has changed. And Sister White is confirmed that the church is no longer following Christ the leader. A separation between the woman and the flood that came from the dragon. Now, Christ has also talked about this separation. We've seen from a prophecy that it is commingled. For it to be triumphant, for the woman to be separated from the waters must be swallowed by the earth. Now, let's look at Matthew 13, verse 24.
Yes. Another parable, the kingdom of heaven is likened unto a man which sowed good seed in his field.
Mm-hmm.
But while men slept, his enemy came and sowed tares among the wheat and went his way.
Okay. So you see, this event, this parable is the same event as that we've seen in Revelation chapter 12. That Christ has filled, and Christ has seed that sows in his field. But while men slept, the devil comes in and sows his seed also. So the reason why we have tares in a field is to make sure the true seed is the nutrients, they grow taller and make sure the sunshine and everything does not get to the actual seed that God has planted. So you see weeds or tares, they grow than the actual crop. Now, this is also shown by having this power, this spiritual power. And they are more vocal. They have the power to do things in the church, to change God's word. They have that power to do that. But let's go to this. Yes.
Let what grow together.
Yeah. Grow together. fasting. Let them do tomorrow is Sabbath. Let them worship together. Let them do everything together. But until when? Let's finish it.
And in their time of harvest, I will say to the reapers, gather ye together first the tares.
So I want you to start again from verse 30.
Verse 30.
Yes.
Let both grow together until the harvest.
Right.
And in the time of harvest, I will say to the reapers.
Okay. So it says, let both grow together until the time of harvest. So the time of harvest is a time separating the wheat from the tares. But how will he do it? Can you read now after the, when harvest is approached?
And in the time of harvest,
he tells them, gather the tares first. How does he gather the tares first? In early writings, page 27, it says, I should stop a sheep. Some did not. Themselves into bundles for fire. Let's read and hear what it says.
Gather ye together first the tares.
First the tares.
And bind them.
Bind them in bundles. So you find that those who reject the feast are bundled together. Those who reject the kingdom message are bundled together. Those who reject Jesus' new name are bundled together. So the tares in bundles. That's the first thing that is done. Bundle. Those who reject the message, let them unite together. While those who accept the message,
into my barn.
But gather the wheat into my barn. So there is a place that God has called a barn. A barn is a garner. A garner is the kingdom that God has prepared for his wheat, for his saints that accept the message of the judgment of the living. So it takes the wheat into the garner. That's what it says. This is the work of the judgment during the judgment of the living. Shall we proceed?
Another parable.
Also, go to Matthew 25. This one. Yes.
The kingdom of heaven. Okay. Like heaven.
So when is that by saying then, it means it's a continuation from this chapter 24. But let's go on to with Matthew 25. Then shall the kingdom of God.
Then shall the kingdom of God.
Yes.
Be like an ancient virgin.
Yes.
Which stood before to the bridegroom.
Yes.
And five of them wise. Five of them were foolish.
So the kingdom of God is like an ancient virgin. Five foolish, five wise. Right? They are left and went to miss the bridegroom, yes.
And five of them wise.
Yes.
And five of them foolish. That were foolish took their lamp and took no oil with them.
Yes.
But the wise took oil in them in their hearts.
So the wise is the wise had extra, whereas the foolish had oil in their vessels on in their lamps only. So the oil in the lamps which was shining was the message from 1844, the judgment for the dead. That was the one that the church was declaring since 1844. It was in the Lamb, right? But the wise virgins had both oil in the lamp and the oil in the vessels. So the extra oil must be then the message for the judgment of the living. Yes.
For the bedroom time, mm-hmm. the old lamp was left.
Yes.
And at midnight, mm-hmm. there was a cry made.
Yeah.
Behold, the bridegroom coming, mm-hmm. going out to meet him.
Mm-hmm.
Then
okay. So it says, while the bridegroom tarried, they all slumbered and slept. So can you see that both the wise and the foolish slept? Is asleep. And even the testimonies testify the same. Let's go to Gospel Workers 92, 121.2. Gospel Workers 92, it's 92 edition, 121.2.
Into.
Yes.
A great work must be accomplished for ministers, mm-hmm. in order for them to make the preaching of the truth a success.
Yes.
The word of God should be thoroughly studied.
Mm-hmm.
All other reading is inferior to this.
Yes.
A careful study of the Bible will not necessarily exclude all other reading.
Yeah.
Religious nature.
Right.
But if the word of God is studied prayerfully,
mm-hmm.
all reading which will have a tendency to divert the mind from it, mm-hmm. will be excluded.
Yes.
If we study the word of God with interest,
mm-hmm.
and pray to understand it,
mm-hmm.
new beauties will be seen in every line.
Mm-hmm.
God will reveal just truth so clearly them that the mind would derive sincere pleasure.
Yes.
And have a continual feast as its comforting and sublime truths are unfolded.
Mm-hmm.
Those who engage in the business of school teaching,
mm-hmm.
prepare for the work.
Mm-hmm.
They qualify themselves by attending the school.
Mm-hmm.
And interesting their mm-hmm. minds.
I'm sure we are not reading the one that I want. Is that Gospel Workers 92? Have you seen it?
Mm-hmm. Ministers should become Bible students.
Mm-hmm.
But trust with the end of matter. Then they should seek to handle it skillfully.
Mm-hmm.
That to be clear and strong. That is fair.
Yes.
A listless, unfeeling manner of presenting the truth will never arouse men and women from their jet-like slumber.
Mm-hmm.
They must show by their manners, mm-hmm. by their acts, and by their words, and by their preaching and praying,
yes,
that they believe that Christ is at the door.
Yes.
Men and women, I asked our question, and yet I
realized that. So this is where we are now. It says men and women are in their last hours of prophecy. Yes. And yet,
careless,
yes,
stupid. Mm-hmm. And preachers have no power to rouse them.
Who are in their last hours of probation. That's what SOP is saying. Yes.
They are asleep themselves.
They are asleep themselves. Yes.
Sleeping ministers.
Sleeping ministers who are preaching.
Preaching to sleeping people.
And preaching to sleeping people. This is what was seen through SOP, that the ministers are asleep, preaching to sleeping people. That they tell them the camp meeting is in August. No one checks it up in the Word of God to see whether August is there in the Bible or it is a time for the feast. Nobody checks that. So that's why it says sleeping ministers preaching to sleeping people. Okay, let's move on to Matthew 24, verse 42. We know in 1844, the Millerite movement made the midnight cry. But in our time, who makes the midnight cry? Shall we look at Matthew 24? Verse 42.
Verse 42.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So when it says watch, therefore, it says don't sleep. Yeah, to watch is not to sleep. It is to read the word of God and observe what is being fulfilled. Yes.
Watch therefore.
Yeah.
For ye know not what hour your Lord doth come.
Mm-hmm.
But know this, that if the good man of the house know in what watch he would come, he would have watched.
So Christ is likened and when he comes to judge the living, he's likened unto a thief. So when we don't watch, we will not know when we are
judged.
Right?
Therefore, be also ready.
If we never suspect, then judgment starts. Yes.
Made the ruler over his household,
mm-hmm,
to give the meat in due season.
Yes. So God wants a people who watch and give meat in due season. Give the present message. Give the message that is required at that hour. The message. So many people create messages. Now that they take us off the order of God, but God wants the message of the Lord. It is a message from God that to
give them meat in due season. Seven.
Mm-hmm.
Whom his Lord, when he cometh, shall find so doing.
Right.
I say to you,
mm-hmm,
that he shall make him ruler over all his
goods. Yes.
But if that servant shall say in his heart, my Lord, delay this coming, and shall begin to serve his servants, and to eat and drink with the donkey.
Okay. So we have an evil servant who says the Lord delay this. And starts to smite those who cause the church to awaken, those who bring to the church meeting due season. So he starts to smite them. Why are you giving this information? Why are you reading all that? And then smites them and then eats and drinks with the drunken. So you find that evil servant is the one who is now in charge of God's house. Is the one who causes people to relax and think that we still have a long time to go, and who disregard all that God has given us to keeping the feast. So many gifts into the church, not one gift, but many gifts. So when other gifts are now bringing in information that help the church, this other evil servant smites other gifts and disfellowships them. Throughout the world, there are people who have been disfellowshipped. There are people who have been censured for presenting meat in due season. But these people who are disfellowshipped for doing that, they continue to watch. In other words, they continue to read, and God gives them a message. When you look at the broadside, you find that, or any writing page 55, now, you find that God deals with a little income. Light that the other multitude of people who are careless does not receive. So these people with this message are fortified, are given many messages by God that prepares them to the judgment of them. If the Israelites proclaimed the midnight cry, it means there is also unto 10 virgins with 5 foolish and 5 wise. But this is not the whole congregation. There is another congregation that they've smitten, which is no longer part of the 5 foolish and 5 wise. It is outside. Let's see now at midnight, verse 6 again.
And at midnight, there was a cry made.
There was a cry made. So it means who made that cry? It couldn't be anyone from the church, because all of them were asleep. That's what the Bible says. The 5 foolish and the 5 wise were asleep. So they didn't know the time of the bridegroom. It's only those who kept on watching, who kept on studying, who knew the hour of judgment and made the midnight cry. Right? So let's go to verse 7.
Verse 7.
Yes.
Then all those virgins arose.
Yes.
And trimmed their lamps.
Right? And so this midnight cry awakens both wise and foolish. They have to receive this message. They have to be to ripen to their true position. If they are a tear, they must ripen up and show the fruit of tears. If they are a wheat, they must ripen up and show the good wheat grains. So each one gets this awakening call, which makes them take the true position. Yes.
And the foolish said unto the wise,
right?
Give us your oil.
Already it shows there is a group that will have no oil. The lamps have gone out. The oil is finished, and they now want extra oil. It's only the wise with the extra oil. The foolish don't have the extra oil. So they have to ask for the extra oil. And it's midnight when there's gross darkness, where the truth is not in the church. Yes, let's read.
Verse 9.
Yes.
But the wise answered,
yeah,
saying,
yes,
not so.
Yeah.
Lest there be not enough for us and you.
Yes. So they couldn't share their faith. They couldn't share their experience, their knowledge. They couldn't share that. They needed, they told them to go and buy also that extra oil. Let's say them saying that.
But the wise answered and saying,
yeah,
not so, mm-hmm, lest there be not enough for us and you.
Yes.
But go ye rather to them that sell.
Go to them that sell. Go to PSM TV and see that this truth, this is truth. It's there. People will know where the truth is found. And they will not go and check. Check it out. It's there. So this everyone will know where to find the truth. Even today, the church knows who are proclaiming the truth. They know. And this is why when you need to now study to understand where God is met. Because everything is clear. God has not left this testimonies. We just need to read and believe. Just like the people in Noah's time, don't go into the ark and be that. But they said, no, 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 in this terrible heat, we'll die in there. It's the same. God has made a provision, has made a place where we need to meet Christ. And he said, go there, go out and meet the bridegroom. So now, the moment these, the foolish ones go out, Christ comes to the wise, and the profession closes. This is the terrible part of it. But there is the foolish, go and buy the oil, they buy it, they come back. Let's see what they I can foresee them being happy. Oh, this is very simple. It's straightforward. I know this, but you know, people told me it's not this false. But I knew it. You know, people will realize this is true, but probation will be closed. Let's see what the Bible says. Yes. Yeah.
The bridegroom came.
Yes.
And they that were ready went in with him, mm-hmm, to the marriage.
Yes. Yes.
After all the other things, say,
yes,
not the law, open to us.
Mm-hmm.
But he answered and said, verily I say unto you,
so Christ says, I know you not. Why does he say, I know you not? Because he never put them in the church. Tell not where they came from. When the when the church was asleep, when the woman was asleep, the devil brought his people in the church. He brought his tears. He brought a flood. He brought the foolish in the church. So this is why what Christ is saying, even when you were at even when you were this, I know you not. The scripture will say that. Says that. You say, I know you not. This is very painful. When you have, for you, the rest of your life, been keeping, thinking that you are doing a good work for the Lord, and the Lord says, I know you not. Why? Because you have rejected the truth that is coming to purify you. The blood of Christ, you have not to listen to men instead of listening to God. To every soul will come a searching test. Will you obey God or will you obey men? Now, we want to look at Testimonies, Volume 2, page 600.2, and see, the reason that Christ said they should come, they should get out and meet the Lord. And during what times do they meet the Lord? Can you read Testimonies, Volume 2, page 600, paragraph 2? Okay, so already is telling us, comes the brethren to this sacred what? Meetings to meet Christ. So these appointed times we come to meet Christ. Yes.
You come up to the feast. And will do for you that which you need most done.
Yes.
Your farms should not be considered of greater value than the higher interest of the soul.
Mm-hmm. Some make excuses. I cannot come because I need to be doing this in my farm. Yes.
All the treasures you possess, be they ever so valuable,
yes,
would not be rich enough to buy you peace and hope.
Yes.
Which should be infinity gain because of all you have. Pleasures and glories of the show.
Yes. Okay. So you see, God says, come to these sacred festivals. Come and meet Christ. But then we meet Christ. Can you make a feast anyway and then expect Christ to meet Christ? Let's go to Revelation 3, verse 12. See, as we are being judged, as we are being prepared for the kingdom, God is seeing us. And he sees us for the kingdom. Let's read.
Yes. He that overcometh, will I make a pillar in the temple of my God.
Yes.
And he shall go no more out.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll write upon him the name of my God.
Yes.
The name of the city of my God.
Yes.
Which is New Jerusalem.
Yes.
Which cometh down out of heaven from my God.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll write upon him my new name.
Yeah. So you see that we will have three names on our foreheads: God, New Jerusalem, and Jesus' new name. So with New Jerusalem, this is a city of God. So it is a destination of those who are sealed by God. So when it has come to this many convocations, we know there is a place where God has chosen, which will be written on our foreheads. So we have seen that we must settle into this new Jerusalem. So that's the city of God, that's the kingdom of God, which we must accept and have our seal. Let's move on to Esther 1909.
In this address, the promise of being made.
Honor. It says you, a pillar is the strongest a structure in a building. So it says, him that overcometh will I make a pillar in the temple of my God. Yes?
Permanent.
It is permanent. Yes?
The church, mm-hmm. Under the figure of a heavenly building.
Yes.
And when the time comes that yeah. This part of the promise is fulfilled.
You with you cannot move anyone, no matter what. When we are sealed, it's a seal of immortality, and it's a permanent seal that seals for heaven, that seals you for New Jerusalem. Yes, let's move on.
He is the Lord's forever.
You are the Lord's forever, yes.
His salvation is sure.
Yes.
But they mm-hmm. that you have more than this.
Yes.
And address to yeah. That destination.
And we address it to our destination. You see that? So this is why we get New Jerusalem on our foreheads. It is our destination.
It's the New Jerusalem.
It's the New Jerusalem. Not the old Jerusalem, no. But the New Jerusalem. If you go to the Middle East right now, you see these two cities. There is old Jerusalem and there is New Jerusalem. The New Jerusalem. That's their destination. Yes.
They are to have written upon the name of God.
Yes.
Whose property they are.
Yes.
The name of the New Jerusalem.
Mm-hmm.
To which place they are going.
Listen. It says we are to be destined New Jerusalem. To which place we are going. So when that call says, the midnight call says, go out and meet him. It is taking you to New Jerusalem. The message tells you go to New Jerusalem. And this is why you find the message of the feast. God says you keep this feast where? In Jerusalem. Come to this sacred convocation where? In Jerusalem. And this is where you meet Jesus. That's what it says. So if I do this, according to the word, I'm justified by the word. But if you reject and do otherwise, you are disqualified. You disqualify yourself.
The name of the New Jerusalem.
Yes.
To which the place they are going.
Yes.
Not all Jerusalem.
Not all Jerusalem. Yes.
Some are very good looking.
No, some are very good looking for Jerusalem. But in Jerusalem, go there, you see there is a difference between all Jerusalem and Jerusalem. Yes.
And they have upon them the new name of Christ.
Yes, they have upon them the new name of Christ. Yes.
Whose authority?
Mm-hmm. Jesus has a new name, and this new name must come on your forehead. Has ever anyone told you you need to be sealed by New Jerusalem? Has anyone ever told you that you need to have a seal of God? God, New Jerusalem, and Jesus' new name. Three names on your forehead. Has anyone ever told you that? Of the living. What is the people who are to be translated there in Jerusalem? So that they have their hearts changed from a stony heart to a fleshy heart, so that they have their sins forgiven, washed away by the blood of Christ. Now, let's leave it there. Can you go to
90, 62.2.
Christ is coming to establish his kingdom. Where? On earth. Christ is coming to establish his kingdom on earth. That's what it is. So,
let our hearts be sanctified.
Yes.
And used to glorify.
Yes.
Let us work now, mm-hmm. as we have never worked before.
Right.
We are exhorted to
mm-hmm.
be instant in season.
Yes.
Out of season.
Right.
2 Timothy 4 verse 2.
Mm-hmm. So Christ is coming to establish his kingdom on earth. This is at his invisible coming. This is why he says he comes as a thief. You don't realize that he is now in the church. He is judging the church. He has come. It is invisible coming to establish his kingdom. Remember, we need to understand all the prophecies of the kingdom as proclaimed in Daniel chapter 2, verse 44. Can you read it? Daniel 2, 44. Daniel 2, verse 44.
Verse 44.
Mm-hmm.
And in the days of these kings,
yes.
shall the God of heaven mm-hmm. set up a kingdom,
mm-hmm.
which shall never be destroyed.
Yes. So you see that the kingdom is set up in the days of these kings. These kings are the kings of the 10 toes. So in the days of the last generation, the 10 toes, God set up a kingdom on earth. You see that? So it means that God is now setting up his kingdom. He is using those that have been sealed, that have accepted the judgment for the living message. So our duty now is to look for this extra oil, the judgment for the living, so that we are sealed for the kingdom. May God help us all so that we settle, so that we are not found to fight the straight testimony that has come to the church. So that he helps us to work out our salvation with fear and trembling. So that we are cleansed by the blood of Jesus. So that we don't fight the messenger of God. May God bless us. This is our message for the night. As we enjoy the Sabbath, and let's continue to search and search. If you have any problems, any questions, you can use the sealing message